I hope you can see my screen. I'm Kostis Triantafyllakis, and today I'm going to present GRLU, a GNU radio space channel simulator that was built in the context of SDR Makerspace. So, first, let me give you the roadmap of the presentation. First, I will try to describe what GRLU is and what it's actually capable of doing. And then I will discuss on some motivation we had initially before even starting to implement this project. Then I will follow with a bird's eye view on the architecture of GRLU, and also I will mention some implementation decisions that we had to make. And finally, I will conclude by giving you some interesting use cases where GRLU might be found handy. And also a live demonstration of a simple simulation run by GRLU. So GRLU is actually what the title implies. It's a simulator for the telecommunication channel between an orbiting satellite and a ground station based on Earth. And its core functionality can be described by three main functions. First, GRLU is able to estimate the satellite trajectory given an observation time frame. And in fact, the thing that GRLU is most interested in is the estimation of the path from the acquisition of a signal through the loss of signal for a specific point of observation. Second, GRLU calculates and applies a set of impairments that can be induced by the telecommunication channel, and the application is made on the transmitted signal from a satellite to the ground station and vice versa. And finally, after the simulation is over, GRLU exports specific artifacts like a simulation log file and an attenuated signal. So our first thought before even starting implementing GRLU was that it would be great for space telecommunication engineers and satellite builders to have a tool that would allow them to debug and evaluate their systems under realistic channel conditions. As we know, simulating these realistic channel conditions in a lab can be a very hard task. This can be even more hard in the case of space telecommunications. So we also wanted the calculation of this type of impairments to be as reliable as possible. So we try to follow and advise specific standards so that we have a solid base in our implementations. Moreover, as long as the implementation of this system is based completely on software, we thought that we should try to build the GRLU as modular and as easy configurable as possible in order to give the opportunity to users to experiment with GRLU and even expand its capabilities by contributing back to the project. And this is also a motivation in order to provide open source software that it's actually a very strict motivation for us. We need to provide open source software to the community, get our software tested, and also get big feedback for the experiments done with GRLU. Regarding the implementation, GRLU is based on GNU Radio, and for those who don't know, GNU Radio is the leading open source framework for developing software-defined radio. And GRLU is built as a out-of-tree module of GNU Radio. And this, in a few words, means that GRLU wraps its functionality into specific blocks that form a module that extends the basic functionality of GNU Radio. There are five building blocks for a basic simulation in GRLU. Each block represents a key element of space channel simulation. So we have a block for a tracker, a block for satellite, block for different types of antennas, and of course a block that wraps the set of the impairments that GRLU is able to estimate. And of course a block that is there to incorporate the functionality of GRLU with the built-in signal processing blocks of Blue Radio in order to expand even more the capabilities and the potential of GRLU. As I said earlier, the first and the key function of GRLU is to estimate the trajectory of the satellite. And this is done in GRLU by using an external open source library that is able to estimate the trajectory of an orbiting satellite by taking as input a two-line element set of the satellite and the observation time frame. And the output of the estimation is a complete path. And having this information, we are now able to estimate the attenuation to each distinct point alongside this path. So the next core functionality of GNU Radio is the impairment calculation, and GRLU implements and considers a relatively limited for now set of impairments for which we advised the ITU recommendation standards that are open for everyone to follow. So we made this decision in order to have a solid base and understanding of how these impairments are estimated. So GRLU considers the free space path loss attenuation, Doppler shift, and two more attenuations that are imposed by the atmosphere, the atmospheric gas attenuation and precipitation. The interesting part here is that these attenuations are estimated in every point during the trajectory of the satellite, and this is crucial because, as we know, these attenuations are dynamic and highly related to the motion of the satellite during its path. And finally, when the simulation is over, GRLU is able to produce some of the following artifacts. First, we are able to export a full simulation log file in CSV format, where every calculation that is done during the simulation is included. And also by exploiting the capabilities of GNU Radio, we are able to actually export the impaired signal in raw IQ recordings. So having discussed about the architecture of GRLU, let me give you some useful use cases where GRLU could be used. The most recent example is the usage of GRLU for the design of the twin cubic Wicket cubes, where GRLU was used in order to estimate the link margin. But one can also use GRLU in order to experiment with transmission and reception by providing and tuning with different values the appropriate comms related fields of the different blocks. In addition, if we imagine a scenario where we could use, for example, another out of the module of GNU Radio, for example, GRLU, where GRSAT, sorry, where different type of decoders are implemented, we can integrate GRLU with different decoders in order to characterize their performance and evaluate them without the need of actually receiving real satellite signals. And finally, GRLU can be used for GLU and frequency drift validation, where the values used on GRLU can be compared with the observed ones to conclude to some results. So I would be happy to see more people to clone the project with the repository of GRLU and run their own experiments and contribute back also with their ideas. And all this can be discussed on the community of LibreSpace, where there is also an open topic for GRLU. That's all, and let's proceed to a demo, if there is time.
Yeah, there is 2 minutes more.
Okay, so
a couple of questions.
I will be quick. So this is the interface of GNU Radio. As we said, GRLU is an out of tree module, so we can see all the related blocks here in the sidebar alongside with the core blocks GNU Radio. And this is a very simple simulation where a PSK modulated signal is passed through the Leo channel model, and next is visualized. So we can see here that we have different blocks representing the satellite and the appropriate configuration, let's say the PID and the RF configuration of the satellite. We also have configurable blocks for the antenna and for different types of antennas, where they are implemented in the manner of variables. So you define antennas and you can use them as a variable, as an input to the configuration blocks of satellite and tracker. So there is a tracker block where we set the actual position of our ground station, an observation time frame, and again the RF configuration of the tracker. And of course, again, the antennas for the tracker, and of course, a block that represents the LEO model, and we can explicitly activate or deactivate different types of attenuations. And of course, here is the block that connects GRLU with the other building blocks of radio. So if we run this flow graph, we can see that the simulation starts. We can see here the log file that is created during the simulation, and we can see here a specific pass for a satellite where the attenuation varies during the pass. And also we can see here the Doppler shift. And that's all. Thanks a lot for your time, and sorry for the rush.
Excellent, Kostis. Right on time. Thank you for the presentation. Let's go quickly through some of the questions. So regarding the ITU impairment calculations, John asks that those are based on the probabilities and what probability was used, and does the tool allow for dynamic variation of these impairments? Like, for example, if the rain attenuation can change over contact?
To be honest, I can't recall the exact probability. But of course, GRLU is built in a way that is very tunable. So I'm sure that the probability can be easily configured. I can see the probability. I can't recall it right now. So.
Okay. Next one would be if this module can be used for correcting preliminary TLE parameters. I think that what Matthias is asking there is probably about orbit fitting.
I'm not quite sure, but you can use any type of constructed TLE and then compare if this is a question that. As far as I can understand, you can use a TLE and then compare with actual observations.
Okay. The next one is: did you consider implementing the propagation delay? Because this could be interesting for simulating a ranging, for example.
There are several things that could be implemented to extend the capabilities of GRLU. As I said, the set of attenuations is a bit limited. Yes, it would be an idea, and also we had some other ideas about extending enhancing the way we calculate the point error loss and double expansion and stuff like that.
Okay. Next question about multipath and if that could be added to the simulation.
I think that for now, in order to calculate multipath, you have to do some modifications. But Leo is implementing a man in a notion where every component is a variable. So yes, with some modifications, we could add a list of satellites in brackets and then calculate multipath.
Okay. The next one is from Frank. So Frank is a double question. Go ahead and
If we use this for channel emulation, so inputting a real source and sync block, let's say, do we have any experiences with existing SDRs and what kind of bandwidth we could then actually emulate using the GRLeo?
Yeah, as far as I know, GLU is already used in that kind of scenario with real SDR devices. I think Manolis or Vasilis tomorrow could present something like that. But I think that you could integrate easily SDR device. And as I showed, you could replace the ability to blocks of radio that simulate a signal source with a real SDR device, and it would be just fine.
Yeah, I think that this will be covered by the SDR testbed presentation tomorrow, so that could be a yes there. There was a question about the GNU radio version, and that's 3.8 right now.
Yes.
And Andre is asking which frequencies are covered in the permanence calculation, because there are a few branches on the ITU recommendations to cover for different frequency ranges.
Yeah, mostly we covered the frequencies that have to do with LEO satellites, but I think you can set a wide range of frequencies with no issue.
Okay. Next one is from Bob. How long a time duration is the arc of the intended simulation in orbit count?
Sorry, can you please read?
Yeah, I think that Bob is asking here what's the maximum probably or whether that Bob, if you are on the line and you can pick up the mic.
Sure. How many orbits do you intend to use in your simulation?
Ah, okay. I think that you can set a relatively big time frame, and all the passes that are calculated inside this observation time frame would be simulated. And also there is a feature that I'm going to implement in the following days where you can skip time. So yes, you can simulate multiple passes inside the observation time frame.
Thank you.
There's another request about if you can share again the flow graph, the flow chart once more. That would be nice. And then a question from Nicolas related to John. If propagation time series are generated randomly based on the ITU model, how the dynamics, the slope, is calculated, because this is normally not covered in the ITU model, and if it's possible to use random seeds to rerun a simulation and reproduce the same results?
To be honest, for starters, we did some assumptions that the models are a bit more simple than what you described, but and also the seeds are not supported, I think. So it would be a nice idea to implement as a future goal.
Excellent. And with that, we are on the 20-minute mark, which is fantastic and on time.